good afternoon. Good night. I don't know. Good day, mate. Jess is just getting home for lunch. I worked all day.
We're both tired.
It's 11:30 p.m., but we are dedicated to the cause. So we're gonna make almost one take style, but I'm sure we'll edit it a little bit.
Yeah.
We're just gonna do, Jess asked some questions on her Twitter. We're just gonna answer them real quick. Also, I'm gonna talk real quickly about what happened when I got off work. So I got off work at 7, right? Mm-hmm. Went on a hunt for what I wanna get you for Christmas, and I can't find them anywhere. And it's awful. And I just...
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm not defeated, but a little disappointed.
What are you looking for?
So that's how I feel. Jess already has stuff wrapped under the tree for me. I have nothing. But I did get you some candy.
Yeah.
I bought these for you.
Thanks, baby.
You're welcome.
I love these.
And I bought something else for you. Starbucks Instant Refresher Revitalizing Energy Strawberry Lemonade.
Those sound really good. Maybe I'll take one to work.
For energy.
You put it in water? Just in the water?
Sure.
Yeah, you do. I'll take one to work.
Can I open it? Yeah. I bought that for you.
Thank you, baby.
I feel better. And... also,
got candy canes.
I got you some candy canes.
Thank you. I saw those over there, but
I don't know what I was doing today. I don't know what's going on, but I feel weird. I got home at like 10. This is what I got. This is what I got for you. Not what I was looking for.
Oh, so you haven't been here?
No.
I thought you've been home this whole time.
No. Only since 10. It's a weird day, you guys.
Well, let's answer some questions.
Don't
blame me. Okay, so I took to Twitter to have you guys ask us some unique questions. You guys had some good ones. I liked a lot of them. They were making me laugh. At IDK Michelle, she asked us, if we were in the apocalypse, what would be our weapon of choice? And who from The Walking Dead would we want on our squad? Wolverine hands.
Oh my gosh. The Walking Dead premiere my family gets really into, and the last 2 years we've been like dressing up and stuff. Not like a ton. Just kidding, the first year we dressed up a ton.
Yeah, we did. We went all out that year.
But this last year we were just kind of like dressed like apocalypse-y.
Not zombies.
And I was like, find what would be your signature weapon? And she was like, nunchucks. And I was like, you want nunchucks in a zombie apocalypse? That's the worst.
Something like that.
And then she's like, oh, no, I got it. Wolverine hands.
But imagine having Wolverine hands
until your hand gets stuck and you're like, oh crap.
No, it'd be something, I don't know if mine would be a gun, because in all reality, you could eventually run out of ammo. Like,
that's why you want a bow and arrow.
No, I don't want a bow and arrow. But if I could choose someone from The Walking Dead to be on my squad, I was thinking about this at work. I was thinking, would I want Rick? Rick would be good. But I think who I would really actually want would probably be Daryl.
Daryl? I would say Carol.
Oh, Carol's good. She's like a chameleon.
Carol does what needs to be
done. She's a chameleon. She's a good one.
I'm slightly worried she would kill me.
In your sleep.
But I would choose Carol.
So this one was asked by @anxiety.
I don't think it's anxiety.
I don't know. Sorry, I can't pronounce that. But it says, when you eat a taco, do you tilt your taco or do you tilt your head?
I tilt my head.
I think I tilt both.
Yeah, I meet in the middle.
I kind of tilt and eat both, yeah. This question was asked by @TJ. Christ 44.
Is your last name really Christ?
Yeah.
Because that's incredible.
So favorite Harry Potter film slash book and favorite house. So I gotta be honest with you, I only read the first book, and that's because we read it in grade school. After that, I haven't read them. Favorite movie wise though, I would say I do like Half-Blood Prince, but I do like Sorcerer's Stone and Chamber of Secrets.
You just named three of the seven.
That's fine. And my favorite house is, I actually belong to Hufflepuff. So I think I'm gonna say Hufflepuff, even though I do like Dumbledore.
Dumbledore?
Shoot, I do like...
You're making me angry.
No, I do like...
Shoot, what is the main one?
Gryffindor! Gryffindor. I do like Gryffindor, but I do belong to Hufflepuff.
So I actually haven't read any of the books. I tried reading the first one when I was a child, and I was like, I don't want to read about this boy who lives in a cupboard or whatever.
That's actually like a, yeah, or that's Indian in the cupboard.
Lives under the stairs, yeah. Whatever. I wasn't into it, but I do love the movies.
I do, yeah.
So I really do need to read the books or get them on like audiobook or something. But my favorite movie is The Goblet of Fire.
Ooh, yeah, that's a good one.
And I don't know if it's my favorite house because it's evil, but I belong to Slytherin.
Yes.
And I'm kind of into it.
Yes. This next question is asked by @YongKong.
YongKong.
Opinion on pineapples on pizza?
Absolutely not.
Fruit should never be on pizza unless it's a fruit pizza. Fruit pizza is freaking good though.
Yeah.
So no, never pineapple on pizza. We have a couple football ones. One is asked by @DexterUmer, and he's asking if we would choose Tom Brady or Aaron Rodgers. I would choose Tom Brady.
I personally like them both a lot.
Yes, I do too.
But I do just think Tom Brady is incredible. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people think he's like a cheater and a baby and stuff. I don't care. I think he's really good.
And then the other one was by Marbs84. It says, what do you think? Guys think of the Niners trading for Jimmy Garoppolo. I think it's brilliant. I'm so happy we got him.
I wouldn't quite say brilliant because we haven't seen a whole lot of this guy, but
yeah, you're right.
I like it. One, I'm excited about it too. And I am very hopeful because he's trained under Tom Brady and Bill Belichick. So,
and he played really well when Brady was out for them.
Right, but that was like all we've
seen. I know, but
so overall, I'd just say like hopeful.
I think there's a lot of potential there for him, a lot. So I'm hoping it will go well. @LoveInRed asked us, Backstreet Boys or NSYNC?
NSYNC. I thought you were gonna agree with me.
I like Backstreet. Well, it's hard because there's such good songs on both sides, but I think I listen to more Backstreet Boys songs.
I love both of them, but I would say NSYNC because me and my best friend growing up were obsessed with NSYNC, and that was my very first concert ever, and it was amazing.
It's coming from @CagelessKingdom, and they ask, are you excited for season 5 of The 100? I am really excited for it. She is not.
Listen, I liked The 100. I was 100% in watching it. Took me like 2 seconds to get all the way through it on Netflix. But I think that a few of the deaths were so unnecessary that I can't even handle it. So I haven't watched season 4. So we'll see.
@JellIFS.
Jell Ifs.
Jell Ifs. So it's Jessica L. Gifs.
Which is a quality.
It is. I love Twitter it. Counts. I love it. I love it. Would you guys want a big or an intimate wedding? We actually have talked about this quite often, and it's going to be more of an intimate wedding.
Yeah. I think mostly just family and really close friends. We've even talked about maybe doing a destination wedding.
Yes.
Which I really, really want to do.
I feel like there's more chance of it being a destination wedding than not. So
I hope so. That.
And it will be sooner rather than later. A lot of people ask if we are ever going to get married. And that is a yes.
We will.
Yes, we will get married. and it will be sooner rather than later. At Shay26Purple, she asked, what is your favorite Nike sneaker of all time?
And then big shout out to Shayla.
Yes.
You are awesome.
Yes.
Do you wanna go?
That is such a hard question to answer because I like so many styles. You can go first.
I would probably just have to say the Air Max 1 because I would say that's the sneaker I get the most excited about. It's hard because I don't know that that would necessarily be like the one that I would choose for comfort, but for style, and I don't know, it just gets me the most excited. The Air Max 1 and the Air Max 90 I really like.
Yeah, I probably could have guessed yours. Mine is really hard because I like go back and forth so often on what I love right now. So hard for me. Right now I'm really, really in love with the Vapor Max that they came out with. I love those. The racers have always been one of my favorite shoes that they have. But we have to choose one.
So which one?
Right now I would say the Vapor Max.
Yeah, that's what I thought you'd say.
Every Vapor Max that they've come out with so far, I have absolutely loved. I haven't bought them, but I have loved them. So at IDK Michelle again asked us what our favorite holiday is. I'm pretty sure you guys can guess mine, but mine is Christmas. I love everything about Christmas. Here's little toenails in the background.
I like Christmas too, and Thanksgiving. Mine honestly might be Halloween.
You
I know that's
hyped.
Crazy. I know it's so crazy, and a lot of times Halloween day, we don't even do anything really exciting, but I love the month of October because I like the fall weather, and I just love the month of like spooky Halloween, fall.
I would say Halloween to you. So how do I say this?
Halloween to me is
like Christmas to me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, probably.
Yeah, that I would have guessed Halloween for you.
Really?
Mm-hmm. She just, you get hyped for it. Like,
love
you love it. She gets excited to hang our witch door hangy thingy. Like, you just get excited for everything about Halloween. I would 100% guess that for you. Okay, so my kicks of the day today are, I'll show you the box. Because you guys can guess what that box. I love this box so much, the reflective. But I've talked about this box, so can you guess what it is? You're right, it's a Vapormax.
If you guessed Vapormax,
you are right. Not only are these a Vapormax, but these Vapormax hold a very special place in my heart because they were this year's Vapormax Be Trues. I don't wear these very often, but I absolutely love this shoe. You can see it's the rainbow color on the Air unit. But what I love is that I have never had much luck when it comes to getting a shoe that's either very limited or a drawing, like you have.
I don't have never mind.
You've had pretty good luck lately.
It's decent, but it's not like crazy.
I haven't ever gotten anything that I wanted until these ones. And because these ones, it was a limited quantity release, and you know, you have to, right as they release is when you have to like buy them or you're not going to get them. I was at work when they released, and I just was like praying that I would get them. I got the message from you that said you got them.
No, you got them first.
Oh, I got them first?
Mm-hmm.
Because I never get anything, I kind of was like getting my hopes up. I was kind of being like, you're not gonna get these, it just never happens for you. Went to buy it, you know, it does the spinning wheel processing, puts you in line or whatever, and then it says, you got them. And I almost cried because I was so happy that I got these. These like were all I wanted. They had a few different types of shoes and these were the ones that like, I didn't care about going. I did want to go for the racers, but you had already got them for me at the time. So these were the only pair that I wanted, and I got them, and I love them, and I love the Vapor Max, and those are them.
And we somehow both got them.
We did, we both got them, which
is the very crazy part, because it's It was a way more limited release than I even had any idea.
Yeah.
And we both got them somehow. Yeah, because they resell for like crazy amount.
I haven't even looked.
It's like $450, $500.
Really? Yeah. I'm not ever selling these though. These like hold a very special place in my heart.
Okay, well mine's not as cool as yours. These are just what I wore today, and it's, in my opinion, a very quality sneaker, and I've been very impressed with it, and I never thought that I would actually like this style as much as I do. But this is what I wore today. This is the Flyknit Air Force One. Pretty sure it has Ultra. I should get the box, but I'm pretty sure it has Ultra in the name too. Which, if you ever have a sneaker, if you're ever looking at a sneaker that has Ultra in the name, that just means it's ultra light. It means that they've made the sole lighter than it used to be. So you see like that in the Air Forces and the Air Max 1s and 90s and stuff. So that's what the Ultra means if you ever see that in your shoes. I have a pair of those too. Yes, you do. I have these in all whites and in red. I don't have any high tops, but I hear good things about those too. Obviously, you guys have all heard of the Air Force One, even if it was
stomping in my Air Force Ones.
This shoe, it's usually a really heavy shoe, right? This is so light. Like, the first time I put my hands on them, I could not believe it. Yeah, I seriously was like, what the? Because they're just like 10 times lighter than the original, you know, leather silhouette. Really comfortable, really lightweight shoe. I love it for like summertime. Today, when I was at Smith's, this lady hit me with her cart.
I was not
saying that. And didn't even say sorry. And I did like the meme with the Arthur hands. And I was like,
as you were, why? As you were doing this, moving them back and forth, I saw that and I went,
yeah. So I'm gonna have to try to clean those.
It'll come off
today. But yes, I love this shoe. It's very, very comfy.
It is a comfortable shoe. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for submitting questions for us to be able to do this vlog, because without that, we wouldn't have had any footage. So thank you.
But we did it.
And luckily this is my last day of work, so vlogs will actually be interesting again for a few days, because I won't have to sleep all day long. Can film throughout the day. But thank you guys for watching, and we will see you guys tomorrow. Love you guys.
Bye.